Alright, so Escape from Tarkov is one of the most demanding and brutal games to run on a PC. The RTX 4090 is currently the second most powerful consumer GPU available, sitting just behind the new 5090. And with all that power comes a hefty price tag. But is it really worth spending the cost of an entire high-end PC build on a GPU like the 4090 or 5090 for a game that's heavily CPU bound? Or can you get nearly the same performance from something a couple tiers lower like the 5070 Ti? In this video, I'll compare both cards head-to-head to find out if the 4090 offers a meaningful performance advantage in Tarkov, or if something like the 5070 Ti is all you really need. With that being said, let's get right into it. For this test, I was running my Ryzen 7 9800X3D tuned with the plus 200 MHz boost clock override and a minus 40 undervolt to get the most out of the chip. It's paired with 64GB of DDR5 at 6000 sealed 30 with tightened secondary and tertiary timings. If you want all the tuning details on the system, check out the link in the upper right hand corner. Storage is handled by a Gen 5 Aorus 10K M2 and everything is running on a Gigabyte X670E Aorus Extreme motherboard. The 5070 Ti is an MSI Shadow 3X overclock model, and the 4090 is an MSI Gaming Trio. As for the game settings, I use my Pure 80 optimized preset, which is my high texture preset for the best visual to FPS ratio. If you want to see a full breakdown on those settings, check out the video in the upper right hand corner. Each test was run 3 times per resolution, 1080, 1440, and 4K. First offline to get baseline numbers without server and network variables, and then online in live raids. I then took those averages and compared those numbers. At 1080 on stream, in offline mode, the 4090 averaged 183 FPS, just a 5% uplift from the 5070 Ti's 174. The 1% lows were extremely close, 141 on the 4090 and 138 on the Ti. The 0.1% lows only differed by 3 FPS, and overall performance was nearly identical here with minimal gains for the 4090. In 1440, the 4090 averaged 174 FPS, a 6% improvement over the 5070 Ti's 164. The 1% lows improved slightly, up 134 to 140. And the 0.1% lows rose from 117 to 129, a 10% difference there. Modest but measurable performance advantage there. Moving up to 4K offline, the 4090 pulls ahead a bit more with the 171 FPS average, about 8% faster than the 5070 Ti's 158. So the 5070 Ti is actually pretty impressive in 4K here. The 1% lows increased from 129 to 136, and 0.1% lows went up about 8%. Not nearly as dramatic gains as I expected in 4K, but I guess Streets is that heavily CPU bound, even in offline with no bots. In Streets Online 1080, the gap shrinks even more. The 4090 averaged 145 FPS, only 1 FPS ahead of the 5070 Ti. The 1% lows came in at 115 versus 113, and the 0.1% lows were 99 versus 95, all within a 4% range. You're unlikely to notice any real difference between the two cards in this scenario. Streets Online 1440, the performance differences remain pretty subtle. The 4090 averaged 144 compared to 141 on the 5070 Ti. That's only a 2% gain. The 1% and 0.1% lows were almost identical as well. Overall gameplay felt very similar between both cards. In Streets 4K Online, the 4090 maintained its lead with the 144 FPS average compared to 139 on the 5070 Ti. The 1% lows came in at 111 versus 104, and 0.1% lows were 75 versus 67. About a 10% difference on the lows. The smoother lows here are the most meaningful difference between the two in my opinion. In customs offline in 1080, the 4090 averaged around 345 FPS. It's only a minor 3% improvement over the 5070 Ti's 335. The 1% lows were 234 versus 223. And the 0.1% lows were 196 versus 185. Again, small differences that don't feel much different in practice, even though the numbers are a little different. In 1440 offline, the 4090 averaged 307 FPS, 14% faster than the 5070 Ti's 269. Interestingly, the 5070 Ti had a slightly 1% low at 191 versus the 4090's 186, likely due to the run variance, but interesting to note. The 0.1% lows were higher on the 4090 though, 184 versus 178. In customs 4K offline, the 4090 showed its largest advantage yet. It hit 210 FPS on average, a massive 52% increase over with the 5070 Ti's 138. 1% lows were 171 versus 119, and 0.1% lows were 138 versus 114. These differences were clearly noticeable and point to a major uplift in performance on customs as opposed to streets where the difference wasn't as large. In customs online in 1080, the 4090 averaged 211 FPS compared to 203 on the 5070 Ti. It's a 4% increase. 1% and 0.1% lows also rose slightly by around 5 to 7%. Still, both GPUs delivered extremely high frame rates and the gameplay felt nearly identical. In 1440 online, both cards again performed similarly. The 4090 reached 201, while the 5070 Ti managed 198, a marginal 2% difference. The 1% and 0.1% lows also differed by just 2 to 3 FPS, making the experience feel almost the same. Online in 4K, the gap is significant. The 4090 averaged 174 FPS compared to 138 on the 5070 Ti, giving it a 26% edge. The 1% lows were 128 versus 119, and the 0.1% lows came in at 118 versus 106. These gains translated into the most meaningful difference I've seen between the two cards during the entire testing period. Throughout testing, the 4090 averaged around 245 watts of power draw compared to about 218 on the 5070 Ti. I ran both GPUs on the default fan curves, and despite the higher power consumption, the 4090 actually ran slightly cooler, averaging around 58 degrees. Versus 61 on the 5070 Ti. Both cards remained quiet during operation and comfortably cool. So is the RTX 4090 really worth it for a Tarkov focused build? In my opinion, it's massive overkill if Tarkov is your main game. The 5070 Ti already hits the game's GPU ceiling at 1440 with high textures, and even in 4K with DLSS, which currently looks better than native rendering with TAA high, by the way. Unless you're absolutely set on playing Tarkov in native 4K at max fidelity for some reason, because like I said, DLSS 4 looks better than native, or you also play other graphically demanding titles or do heavy creative or editing work, the 4090 just doesn't make much sense here for most people. The 5070 Ti gives you about 85 to 90% of the performance for less than half the price. For most people, that money is going to be better spent on a stronger CPU, faster RAM, or upgrading your monitor, keyboard, or mouse, all of which can have a bigger impact on your experience in Tarkov. Alright, that's all I got for this one. I hope it helped. If you found it useful, please drop a like, subscribe, and hit the bell to stay updated with future hardware comparisons. It really helps support the channel and helps me keep making content for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.